dear children, how are you all? So we were doing a chapter. We have started a new chapter in our great fun with grammar book, and that chapter is chapter 5, gender. Okay, and we have done two exercises in our previous video. Now we'll be doing the further exercises. So I'll be on page number 26, right? Nouns that refer to males are said to be of masculine gender. Okay, so if we are talking about any male, like boy, brother, king, nephew, peacock, cock, right? All these, they belong to masculine gender, right? And nouns that refers to females are said to be belonging to feminine gender, right? For example, girl, aunt, mother, sister, queen, peahen, hen, they all belong to feminine gender. So we have to remember that nouns that refer to males, males belong to masculine gender. Nouns that refer to females belong to feminine gender. Right? Then, nouns that refer to a non-living thing are said to be of a neuter gender. Like there are many non-living things which we generally talk about: table, chair, clock, shelf, wall, almirah, cupboard, house. All these, they are neither masculine nor feminine. So they come under the category of neuter gender. Okay. Nouns that can refer to both male and female are said to be of the common gender. What is the common gender? Common gender means you can refer it to both male or female. For example, teacher. Now teacher, like I am your teacher. Okay, I am a female, so I belong to the feminine gender. If we talk about any male teacher in our school, then that male teacher belongs to the masculine gender. So teacher, it is common. It is common, which we can use in both the cases, whether male or female. For example, friend, cousin, neighbor, teacher, children, students, they all belong to common gender, right? Fine. So again, a quick recap. Nouns that refer to males belong to masculine gender. Nouns that refer to females belong to feminine gender. Nouns that refer to non-living things, they belong to neuter gender. And nouns that refers to both males or females, they belong to common gender. Okay, fine. Now, the first exercise, which is on page number 27. First exercise is, circle the nouns in the box. Follow the instruction. Now, what are the instructions? That if it is belonging to masculine gender, then you should be carrying your green crayon. Circle it with green crayon. Feminine gender, circle it with red crayon. Common gender, circle it with blue crayon. And neuter gender, circle it with black crayon. So for this exercise, whenever we are doing it in the online class, you should be carrying your wax crayons along with you. Okay? Now, the first is teacher. The first is teacher. Now teacher, it can be both male or female, right? It can be both male or female. So we have to circle it with, because it belongs to common gender, we have to circle it with blue crayon. Circle with blue crayon. Okay? Because teacher belongs to common gender, and common gender we have to circle with a blue crayon. Again, aunt. Now, aunt belongs to feminine gender. So, for feminine gender, we need to have a red crayon. So, you are going to circle it, circle with red crayon. Okay? Because Pushpanjali ma'am is right now carrying only black crayon. So that's why I am writing the colors here. In the similar manner, we will be looking at all these intergender, common gender, and accordingly we are going to circle it with the color code which is given here. Fine, two I have done. Rest answers I have provided you in the assignment section. Okay, now moving to the next exercise, which is match the following. Right, now here it is written A policeman, B God, C prince. Okay, here the masculine genders are written and here the feminine genders are written. So we just have to match it along with them. I'll be writing the answers directly here, but when we'll be doing in the class, or if you refer to the assignment section, then you can look at the all or look at all the answers there. So police men. So what can be the opposite gender for it? Police woman. It is police woman. Okay, police man, police woman. God. Goddess, the seventh one, goddess. Okay, prince, the opposite gender of prince is princess, which is on point 10. Okay, so in this manner we are going to match it either along with the letters given on the right side. We can write down the respective letters on the right side of these feminine genders given, right? Or we can match it in the usual manner by the slanting lines. It is totally up to you. I have provided all the answers in the assignment section. Okay, now moving to the third and the last exercise for the day. Rewrite the following sentences, changing the words in color into the opposite gender. Okay, you can see that few words are highlighted with red. Okay, so we have to change them to their opposite gender. For example, it is done in the A part. My aunt is an actress. She has played the part of the heroine in many films. So aunt is highlighted. So what is the opposite gender of aunt? Uncle. My uncle is an actor. He has played the part of the hero in many films. Fine. Now the B part is, we just have to remember that the black words will come as it is and the red words we have to change it to the opposite gender. Fine. My sister has four daughters. They are my nieces. Okay, now what is highlighted? Sister is highlighted in red, daughters is highlighted in red, and nieces are highlighted in red. Now we have to copy the black ones as it is and we have to change the red ones into the opposite gender. So my will come as it is. Opposite gender of sister is brother. Fine. So my brother has four. Opposite gender of daughters is sons. Has four sons. They are my. Now opposite gender of nieces is nephews. Okay. So this is how we are going to convert the red ones into their opposite gender and the black ones will come as it is. Now we'll do one more related to this. The C part is, the landlady wants to see your wife. Now what is highlighted in red in this sentence? Landlady is highlighted, wife is highlighted, right? Now we have to copy the black ones as it is and the red ones into the opposite gender. The, what is the opposite gender of landlady? Landlord wants will come as it is to see your, the opposite gender of wife is husband. The landlord wants to see your husband, right? Anna will be covering the rest of the exercise. The answers I have provided you in the assignment section. You are going to complete all these exercises in a beautiful handwriting. Take care of the formation of letters. Right? Fine. We'll meet in our online class then. Bye.